12 colored t-shirts, running after a football in the Bethlehem University court, each Tuesday and Saturday. They are aged from 12 to 23. They are the girls of the Bethlehem football team, the first soccer team in the Palestinian Territories. Most of them are also part of the national team that has already reached really good results in tournaments in Jordan and Egypt.
I was playing in the neighborhood because the men mentality in our society that believe in that soccer is only for men. And I tried all my best to change this idea and to achieve it step by step. So I entered the university, I met Samar Al-A'raj, the principal of this team, and she started talking to me about the idea of making a team. I began to play football before 3 years. First, I didn't like to enjoy the football team because they were saying that it's for boys and a girl who will play will lose her being as a girl. So I came to a training and I like it. Yani I like the relation between girls. The coach was so nice and friendly. Yani I like the idea and I began to train until I reached the national team. Thanks God.
Yeah. I'm Saruna. I'm 12 years old. I joined the team because I really like football a lot. It's my life. It's my passion and it's my dream. When I was about 5 years old, I started playing with my dad. He taught me football and I started playing with my friends at school. And then I joined a boys team and then I found that there's a girls team, so I joined and they accepted me.
Round, round, get around, I get around, yeah, get around, round, round, I get around.
At the beginning, the idea of girls wearing shorts and playing a typically male sport wasn't widely appreciated due to the traditional society of the occupied Palestinian territories. However, with some compromise on the clothing, the initial gender prejudices have been overcome and the Bethlehem team is now loved and supported by all.
Yeah, start this idea of establishing a football team for girls. It's the first time in Palestine. And I gathered some girls from the university and from the schools around Bethlehem. I asked the coach Raed to start training the girls and to teach them the football skills. And they were good.
العمل التطوعي مع البنات ممتع جدا.
Volunteer work with the girls very excited for him.
خاصة انه كان حلم في حياتي.
Especially it was a dream for him.
كنت احلم من 10 سنين جد يعني. انه كان عندنا فريق يكون عندنا فريق بنات لفلسطين والحمد لله الحلم تحقق.
He was dreaming before 10 years to have a national women's soccer team girl in Palestine, and thank God that now it's achievable.
The harsh economic realities are definitely an obstacle for the collective growth of the team. The lack of funds and an adequate field, sporting equipment, and transportation affect them even more than the prejudices toward women in Palestinian society. But in this sport, as in most aspects of Palestinian daily life, it is the Israeli occupation that leaves a strong mark. The female national team, which was founded about 2 years ago with the participation of girls from Ramallah, Bethlehem, Jericho, and Gaza, is indeed the only team that has to practice in four different places. And because of the limited mobility afforded by the wall and Israeli occupation, they can only gather during the matches abroad.
This is our problem. We can't just gather together to play or practice. You know, other Arab world saw us when we finished from Egypt tournament. We started saying goodbye for each other from us and from Gaza, and they were crying, and we were very sad to leave them. They was wondering why you are saying goodbye for each other because you are from one country, which is Palestine. We explained to them that it's difficult to meet. From that time till now, we didn't meet.
When we go to Jordan, we have to pass through first the checkpoint. We go through Wadi Nar, And when we reach the bridge, we have to first check at the Palestinian part. And then we go to the Israeli part to check the passports and wait for hours. Because they need to see everything is okay with all the girls. They don't have any, you know, thing related to politics. And also to wait for the coach. They always talk with the coach for hours. And then we go to the Jordanian part. Also, we need to stop for checking for hours. So the good in this team that we are working in a team group, you know, help each other, discuss our problems. They cheering others, even if one is not good, they try to help her to be good.
The first person who encouraged me to play, my mother. She came in the local tournaments. She will come, but when we go to championships such as in Jordan or Egypt, she can't. But she will call me and say, yes, I'm seeing you playing. Or
the Bethlehem team's players consider sports as a life choice. Although in the OPT, due to the lack of infrastructure and opportunities, to take up a career in sports is unlikely. They don't give up their passion. Rather, they have found a way to transform it in their future. One such example is Honey, who at the moment is involved in a project for children in cooperation with the Palestinian Ministry of Sport.
This is the first event in Palestine which happens like that. It's about gathering children aged 8 till 14 and give them the facilities to play and prove themselves instead of being out in the streets and so on.
I'm planning to have a team, to train a team in Latin school. We are working on it.
In sports, we often use terms like challenge or fight. These are well-chosen metaphors to describe the style of Bethlehem's girls. Even if their hard work's results aren't immediate, the passion and the bravery isn't lacking, and they are aware that these are the qualities that make the difference in sports and in life.
It's only our motivation. Our motivation is the thing which will support us.
We are just playing with our souls and spiritual abilities. It's because we are strong, we are Palestinian, we face a lot of difficulties. We want to be something and to show the world, even the Arab, even Palestine, to show everybody that we can do something and we can be the best in the future.